everyone, Jillian Honan here. Hope you're all doing well today. I am doing fantabulous. I had lunch up on, if you follow me on Instagram, you know that off of my master bedroom, I have this deck that literally overlooks the valley and it's gorgeous and the sun is out and I don't have to drink my hot water today to make my body warm. Yes, I drink hot water to warm myself. I'm one of those people where I need a good 80 degrees and above. Otherwise I feel cold. So yeah, sorry for the people that live with me. I don't like the AC on very often. But anyway, that is not what I wanted to talk about today. I wanted to talk about the power of no. For all of my friends who find themselves often saying yes when they want to say no, and they live with anxiety and stress and heaviness. And I want to bring something to the table today to set you free, because I don't believe that that's God's will or heart for you to live in that pressure and that burden of always feeling obligated to what other people might think and what other people might feel if you say no, and what they meant, what that might look like on your part. In my book, Life is Muddy, I keep it over here now so that I can refer to it. So Life is Muddy. In one of the chapters, I say not every good yes is a God yes. And I'm not even talking about saying yes to bad things. I'm saying also yes to really good things, you know, because it sounds good, because it's the right thing to do, because it makes you look good, because they need you, you know, and all of these things that we find ourselves saying yes to do, or yes to, yet we are living heavy laden and burdened, which is the exact opposite of what Jesus says that life with him looks like and feels like. One of the things that I have had to really learn and grow in my life is, without realizing it, that is people-pleasing mud that's woven into that. And what happens is there's an underlining fear of man, or insecurity, or fear of what that may look like, or what people might think about you if you say no. That's not freedom. That's putting yourself back into bondage of another form of slavery. That's not God's heart. Jesus says, hold on, I'm going to go get my Bible. Okay, here it is. Matthew 12:28. This is what Jesus says. He says, come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. In the Message version, it says, come get away with me and I will give you a real rest. And then it says, I will show you the unforced rhythms of grace. And I love the verbiage that the Message version gives. I mean, it's just such a beautiful picture of what it looks like when we get away with God. And if you've been following me for any amount of time, you know that I will constantly remind you to get away with God, to spend time with Jesus. And I think of how many times that I talk to my brothers and my sisters in the Christian community where we don't really understand what it means to live a burden-free life, the life that Jesus promises us. You know, how many times are you saying yes? Are you serving, going, being, doing constantly? And is that God's will for you? If you're feeling burdened and heavy, I would say pull back, scale back, and say, God, what do you say? Like I was saying a little bit ago, I went through a lot of years of stripping this underlining truth that I had people pleaser mud inside of me, that I was overcommitting to too many things, and I was feeling the heaviness of life. One of the seasons that I really experienced that was during my single mom years, you know, and I was serving in church and working nights and going to school and building my life coaching business, practice, whatever you want to call it. And I had these different side things going on just to bring in an extra income. And for a season, it was good. The busy was good, but then it got heavy. And I was really surprised when the Lord told me to stop serving at church. I'm like, but that's a good thing, you know? And I was really concerned as to what that's going to look like to other people. I mean, that's just what you're supposed to do. And, you know, you can look at this in any area of your life. You can look at this, you know, is your role as a parent? Are you saying yes to your kids out of feeling like you're going to let them down and you're saying yes to too many things and not practicing healthy boundaries? Is that what your relationships look like in the workplace, at home, at church? Put this into any category of your life and really ask yourself, do I give myself the power to say no, or do I say yes all the time and then live with the stress? That's not God's heart. And it was really interesting that I go to the Lord and he tells me to do less, even the good things that, you know, I feel like I should be doing as a child of God, as somebody who is a part of the bigger picture. You know, I have a servant heart. Anybody who knows me, I have been serving in church since you were old enough to serve in church. I could not wait until I was old enough and they would let me volunteer in the nursery and play with babies all day. Well, on Sundays. And it just, you know, it was a constant trickle effect from there, serving in different ministries and just always behind the scene, moving to different states to be a part of church plants. I mean, I absolutely love serving God and serving the body of Christ. That's why I'm doing what I'm doing. But the importance of making sure that your yes has the grace of God over it. And here are some really simple practical things that I've learned. One, if you have a habit of saying yes when you want to say no, and you are living with stress and anxiety, you are not doing anybody else a favor and you are hurting yourself. And so there's no benefit anywhere. Number two, if you are saying yes when you should be saying no, and you do not have God's grace over it, which would be just feeling this supernatural ability to do more than maybe you could have done without him, but you don't feel the heaviness. You're not burdened and heavy laden, and you're living in that freedom. So when you're feeling heavy and you don't have the grace to do something, here is the truth. Sometimes you have got to say no to the person, even if it's a good thing, because you have to get out of the way because God wants to do something maybe in that person's life or in your life, and your yes is actually slowing down the God process that he has. It's just true. How many times have you said yes because you feel like somebody needs you when really they should be doing this for themselves and you're actually stunting their growth? There was one time where I knew I needed to pull back from just meeting at my house and Bible study, church, you know, church at home. And it was just a time where I knew that God was saying, pull back. I've got some things to do in you and in them. And I really struggled with pulling back. I went to the Lord and he basically told me that I was in his way from doing what he wants to do in me and in them if I continue to say yes to meeting every week when God is saying no. Meeting every week and fellowshipping and getting into the word is a good thing. But if God's grace is not over it, it's heavy. And I was entering into a season where it was extremely heavy and that something had to give. I was shocked when that was it. And I'm not talking about my friends who are professionals at saying no because you have fear. That is for a different message on a different day. We are talking about the power of saying no and trusting God with everything and recognizing where you might have some people pleaser mud inside of you, fear of man, fear of what somebody else might think. And I am telling you right now, your freedom is in living for an audience of one. You are always going to have somebody that disagrees with you. There is always going to be a critic. But when you are rooted in a confident trust with the Lord, and you are trusting him with yeses and nos, and you don't really care. I mean, you might be affected, but you're like, you know what? I'm confident that I need to say no in this one. you're free. And that person is just going to have to wrestle out whatever it is that's causing them to be judgmental and critical. It's wrong. What would it look like if we really only responded to God? Jesus modeled that for us. He really gave us a good template on what it looks like to just walk with his Father in heaven and do what he says to do and go where he says to go and accomplish his good will and purpose. And that's it. He really tuned out when the crowd was trying to get him to stay longer or go somewhere. You know, he did only what the Father told him to do. And there was this peace that radiated from his life when he knew when he needed to pull away and just get with God and really say no to everybody else. And that's our model. That's what Jesus says. It says, follow me. I will show you what it looks like. Oftentimes what I've seen is there's just this confusion in the church where our walk with God looks more like following man instead of actually following Jesus. And then we live with this expectation on ourselves and we don't know how to say no. And I want to challenge you today. If you're feeling really stressed, if you are living with anxiety, and get away with God. Ask him, is everything on your life plate that you've piled on what God wants you to do? His grace is sufficient. And if his grace is sufficient, yet you're feeling heavy and you're asking God to please help, please help, please help. I need your peace. I need your comfort. But you're the one who said yes to things that you shouldn't have said yes to. Then it is your responsibility to start to sift through that life plate and maybe say, I'm sorry, I shouldn't have committed to this. I really have to let it go. I have experienced so many times where God has had me let something go that I really didn't want to, and it was a really good thing. And I had to walk through this undoing process and this underlining truth that I was more concerned about what somebody else would think instead of what God says and just trusting him. There was one time I was really wrestling it out, and this was actually the biggest transition I've ever experienced. It was about 4 years ago, maybe longer, you know, give or take, where Jillian Hona Ministries, we had already established it in 2015, and I was taking those steps into the direction that God had for me, and the Lord told me that my time serving in church was up. He was like, you're serving me fully now in the ministry that I've called you into. And I looked around and I tried to find somebody else to kind of validate, because I was really insecure. And I knew that the areas that I was serving in at church during this time, like, they were already struggling as it is to find people to fill these positions. And so if you're going to church and you're not serving, ask the Lord what you can plug in, because actually you're needed. Okay, there's your little side note plug, but it's true. And so I really, really wrestled this out. And I was on the phone with one of my good friends who lives out this way. And she's like my go-to person, where I just kind of like, blah, you know, and I just share all these things that I'm struggling with. And she helps me put everything into its proper place. And sometimes she doesn't even have to say anything to me. Sometimes I just need, because I'm a verbal processor. So get somebody who's solid and spirit filled, who can kind of help you sift through things and maybe just be a listening ear. Anyway, I was just kind of verbally processing my struggle with the Lord telling me that my time in serving church was up and that I was fully to serve him. And, she said, you know, she said, Jillian, I had to go through that too. And I'll tell you, one thing that I learned is that you have to get out of God's way. And this was really freeing for me, because I didn't look at it from this perspective. I felt like I was letting people down. And that might be, but honestly, that's between them and the Lord. That's on them. You know, we just have to trust and obey God. But for me, she just said, you know, a lot of times people will see a role fulfilled and they won't step into anything because the space is filled. And so if God is calling you out, you need to obey him and trust him because I think he already has somebody lined up for that spot and you're in the way. And I never thought of it like that. So how many times are we actually in the way of God because we feel this pressure to perform and say yes, and it's not what God is saying. It's not what God has for us. He has somebody else in mind. The other thing that I've learned is that when God takes us to another level or the next thing, oftentimes we also have to let go of some things in order to step fully into what he has next for us. And there was a season where I was running my photography business, absolutely loved it. My clientele was building. I was going into different cities in Southern California and I planned on continuing on branching out. And I had all these returning clients and I was loving it. And all of a sudden it just started feeling really heavy. And I'm just like, what in the world? You know, I love doing this. And I went to the Lord and he basically gave me the choice, you know, but I knew that that choice came with the reality that I don't have the grace to do both things. I don't have the grace to where I feel light and free with that easy yoke to serve fully in ministry and also serve my clients. It was taking me into two totally different paths and I needed to let one go. And it was really, really difficult to let my photography business go. It was my creative outlet. And I'll tell you, here's a little side note here. Everything that I learned through that season of running a business and that creative aspect and just the behind the scene editing has really, really helped me with areas of my ministry that I don't have any help. I'm like, you know, a lot of it is on me. And I do believe that God is going to bring people alongside of me to serve in these areas of video and editing and podcasts and all those things that I'm not that good in at all. And I really don't have the time to do it, but I do have a little bit of an understanding that's helped me. So my photography business actually helped me in the season, but I had to let the business side go and step fully into what God had next for me. And I think a lot of times we miss it. We think that God, you know, shows us our next step and we think we have to take everything that we've already been doing along with us. And that's just not always the case. I'm very focused on what God has for me in this season of ministry. And this is where the grace is. This is where I feel free. I do not have a burden. I feel light. I'm not in bondage to what anybody else might think or say anymore. It took me a while, especially when my family and I were plugged into this one church and the pastors were telling me that in order for God to use me, that I needed to submit to this pastor and serve in these particular areas, that, you know, that God needed to humble me. And what was interesting is I was already on a 3-year journey of God undoing this fear of man and this people-pleasing mud in my heart that made me feel like I had to say yes when God was telling me no to even good things that I love. I love serving in church. Like I said, I love being a part of that bigger picture. But it just wasn't what God had for me in that season. And you know, I'm not angry with that pastor. I have no bitterness. I do feel a sadness in my heart because I really hope that he doesn't put that pressure on other people. And maybe that was simply just a test for me to stand before the Lord and be like, you know what? I really have grown in this area. I really am living in the freedom of what it looks like to live for an audience of one and respond only to you. And so I want to encourage you today. Give yourself a voice to say no. No is not a bad word. And I know when you have a toddler and that's their favorite word, it feels super annoying. And that's a whole nother animal, right? But we're so afraid to say no sometimes. We're afraid of what that might make us look like, what people might think about us behind our back. Maybe we've been conditioned to say yes all the time, but it's not God's heart. Nowhere in the Bible does it say yes, does it say to say yes to everybody it only says to say yes to God, follow him and trust him. He has a path and a plan for your life, and it's a good one. And maybe that's what you're struggling with today. Maybe your stress and your anxiety is not in God, please show up and help me, but you going before the Lord and saying, God, what have I said yes to that is not your will for me in this season? And be willing to deal with a reality that you might not be living in the freedom of living for an audience of one. You might still need the accolades and the affirmation from other people that God wants to be the only one who has the power to speak that into your life, because this is your freedom. So I pray that this meets you. I pray that the Holy Spirit fills you with a boldness to say no when it's a good no from God, and that you learn what it looks like to live with a light burden that you learn to live in the freedom and the victory and the lightness that Jesus has for you. Be blessed.